Now the main complaint from the owner is that this dog loses hair, or the hair comes up, not from the front is okay, but more from the back here, there. More hair keeps on coming up. Yeah, so compared to the front, there's nothing. Okay, so then can the dog stand up? Can you stand up?
Rocky, stand, move.
I just see the. Now normally it's due to tail biting or backside biting of the inner glands. The inner set, now you can see the inner, there's some hair loss here, see? So this one is an itch. Itch on the inner sac. Normally this one should be not so red. But it starts starting, so it's not much. Now, the main problem I asked the owner is that does the dog scratch the leg with the hind leg? And how many times a day?
Quite a few times.
Both legs,
right?
Yeah. And
also scratch
the neck? Yeah, neck especially. So, they scratch the neck. So, these are signs of ear irritation. In fact, sometimes become hairless. I see it become hairless here. Also, if it goes on scratching, of course, the hair will drop. Okay? So, these are the clues. Now, just a physical examination, you can see that this ear is very dirty. All you have to do is just put the cotton bud in. You see the dirt, the wax. Then this side, so what do you put inside the ear?
Nothing.
So you didn't clean the ears. Since when?
Since we got him from last
year. So, for how long?
For 1 year, coming to a year.
So it's considered quite good, the ear is not very dirty because of the shampoo goes going in and the dampness. So it's not painful, you see that? It's not painful. So does the dog shake his head?
Shake.
Shaking the head.
Only shower.
Shower.
Okay.
So overall, I would say it's not a serious problem. So what we do is just do the ear irrigation and express the inner sac. Okay, finish it.